Today, we're going to discuss voice parts. Some of y'all may already know most of this information, especially if you've been in chorus for like a year or two already. So for you, this is going to be a good review. For those of you who have never heard any of this information before, that's totally fine too. After we've been through the characteristics of each voice part, everyone's going to think about which one they think their voice might naturally be, and then we'll kind of share what we think our answers are. The voice parts that we are most commonly using for choir singers in order from highest to lowest are going to be soprano, alto, tenor, baritone, and bass. So there are a few others that are used, but for middle school voices, these are the ones we're going to talk about. So the first voice part we'll talk about is soprano. Soprano is the highest voice part, and the range of a soprano usually goes from what we call middle C up to an A5. Sopranos usually sing the melody, which means it's a little easier to learn, but it might be more challenging for some people because it sits higher for the majority of the time. It's usually sung by a girl with a naturally high singing range, but it can also be sung by other genders. In middle school, boys whose voices have not dropped yet can usually sing soprano easily, and some boys can actually still sing soprano even after their voices have dropped. So soprano is also the most common voice part. Most girls are sopranos, especially in middle school. So I'm just going to show y'all a few examples of each of these parts. I'm going to give you a classical example first of sopranos. This is a woman named Shin Yong-ok, and she is a soprano from South Korea. And here's a musical theater example. Y'all have probably seen Julie Andrews sing the song Do a Deer to learn about solfege. That just goes, Do a deer, a female deer. Y'all have probably all sung that song before. Julie Andrews is an American actress, singer, and dancer. And the song I'm actually going to show you is called The Sound of Music. And it's from the same musical as Do a Deer, which is also called The Sound of Music.
Have sung for a thousand years.
And for the last example here, this is going to be a pop singer who's also a soprano, and that is Ariana Grande. So hopefully y'all have all heard her sing before. She's also an American singer, songwriter, and actress. She has a 4-octave vocal range, which is pretty wide. And she also is kind of famous for being able to sing whistle tones, which are a higher singing range, and we call them that because their quality can be kind of whistly. And this actually is going to be a video of Ariana Grande demonstrating some of her whistle tones.
I just wanted to make this video of me doing some live whistle tones. They're not pretty. I don't think they're pretty.
The second voice part we're going to talk about is alto. Alto is the second highest voice part, and the range of an alto usually goes from the F that's below middle C up to a D5, which is, so we've got middle C and then the C above that, and then D5 is right above that. So it's usually sung by a girl with a naturally low singing range, but again, it can also be sung by other genders. In middle school, boys whose voices have not dropped yet can usually sing alto easily, like even more easily than soprano, and some boys can still sing alto even after their voices have dropped. We have a lot of girls who end up singing alto because they like singing a harmony part, but it's actually pretty rare to find what we call a true alto. Alto can be a little easier for some people because it's not as high as the soprano part, but it can also be more challenging to learn because in chorus they sing harmony and not the melody like the sopranos do. So here's a classical example of an alto singer. This is Jessie Norman, who's an American opera singer. This is her singing a bit of Amazing Grace, but she's actually sung a lot of different musical styles.
Amazing.
example is going to be kind of a musical theater example. It's one of the altos from an a cappella group called Voctiv, singing a musical theater song. They're from Central Florida, and they mostly sing Disney songs. This one is not. I think this alto's name is Christy Johnson. So here's an example of her singing pretty low.
Any note you can sing, I can sing lower.
I can sing any note lower than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
And for this next example, it's going to be a jazz one because a lot of famous jazz singers are altos. This is going to be Ella Fitzgerald, who hopefully y'all have heard of. She was a very famous American singer and songwriter. And she was really especially famous for being able to scat for like 7 minutes at a time. So scatting is when you sing like nonsense syllables and you kind of try to imitate what an instrument would sound like. So here is Ella Fitzgerald.
Somewhere there's music, I'll paint the tune. Somewhere there's heather, when love is far away too, till it comes true that you love me as I love you. So come where there's heaven.
And the last example is going to be of a pop singer. So hopefully y'all have heard Adele sing before. She's a British singer-songwriter, and here's a little clip of Adele singing.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your ship bare.
All right, the third voice part we're going to talk about is tenor. Tenor is the third highest voice part, and the range of a tenor usually goes from, we call it a B2, so we've got middle C here, and then the C below that, and then B2 is right below that. And that goes up to what we call an F4, which is right above middle C. It's usually sung by a boy whose voice has already changed, but who still has a naturally higher singing range. It can also be sung, again, by other genders. Sometimes girls end up singing tenor because that's where their voices naturally feel comfortable, but that's actually pretty rare. Tenor can be a little challenging because they also mostly sing harmony, just like the alto part would do. So for your classical example, this is going to be José Plácido Domingo. He's a Spanish opera singer, and he performed opera in a lot of different languages. This one happens to be in Italian, and it's called Nessun Dorma. The next example is going to be a musical theater one. This singer is Andre DeShields, and he is an American actor and singer. This song is called Ain't Nobody's Business If I Do, and it's from a musical called Ain't Misbehavin'.
If I see my wife alone, don't pay my alimony, ain't nobody's business if I do.
My wife will be the slave.
If I buy you just a phone, lift it up before I'm born, it ain't your business.
And our last example is going to be of a pop singer. Hopefully y'all have heard of Justin Bieber, a Canadian singer and songwriter. When he was discovered from singing covers on YouTube, his voice actually hadn't changed yet. So here's a little clip of him just singing a cover on YouTube from when he was like a teenager, preteen, before his voice had dropped.
I need to blue. I gotta see you blue. And those hearts all over the world tonight.
So now that his voice has changed, he's actually a tenor. So here's a little clip of Mark My Words from 2015.
Mark my words, that's all that I have. Mark my words, give you all I got in every way I will. You're the only reason why, oh, I don't wanna live a lie. Mark my words, mark my words.
And the fourth voice part we're gonna talk about is bass. Bass is the lowest voice part, and the range of a bass usually goes from what we call E2, which again, we've got middle C, and then the next C below that, and then so we've got C, B, A, G, F, E. So it's significantly lower than what we talked about for the tenor range. And they can usually sing up to a C4, which is what we call middle C. It's usually sung by a boy whose voice has already changed and has a naturally lower singing range, but again, it can also be sung by other genders. It's somewhat rare for a sixth grader's voice to have already dropped this far, but I have seen it happen several times. Bassists sing harmonies like tenors and altos do, but it's not usually as challenging to learn as tenor or alto might be. So it would still be harmony. They would not be singing the main part, but the harmony part tends to just kind of be a little bit easier for people to hear in your head. So for our classical example, this is going to be David Jerusalem. He's a German opera singer. The piece is called O König, and that's kind of a creepy song with a weird, like, translation and story and stuff, but here is David Jerusalem. Example is going to be a musical theater one, kind of. It is from a movie that has musical-like qualities, so I thought some of you might have seen the animated version of The Jungle Book. In this version, a guy named George Sanders plays Shere Khan, the tiger, and he is a super deep bass singer, so here's an example of that.
That's what friends are for.
Bravo, an extraordinary performance.
And for our last example, this is going to be a pop singer. There are actually more tenor pop singers than bass singers for some reason, but there are actually a lot of country bass singers. So Josh Turner is one of them. He's an American country singer. So here's a bit of Why Don't We Just Dance.
Baby, why don't we just turn that TV on?
And the last voice part we're going to talk about is baritone. Baritone actually lies in between tenor and bass, and the range usually goes from an A2, which again, we've got middle C, and then the C below that, and then if you go C, B, A, that's where an A2 is. And it'll go up to D4, which is right above middle C. It's usually sung by a boy whose voice has already changed and who has kind of a middle singing voice, but again, just like all the other parts, it can also be sung by other genders. Unfortunately, most middle school boys end up getting thrown into the baritone section, whether they are truly a tenor, a baritone, or a bass. And that's because it's easier to get a section of kids who are in the middle of voice change to sing the same notes together than it would be for them to sing a couple of different harmony parts at the same time. This means that just because since you're all kind of pooled into the same singing part, that if you're singing baritone, but you're actually a tenor, or your voice hasn't dropped yet, so you're still technically an alto or a soprano, some of the notes are going to be a little too low for your voice right now, and that's completely fine. This also means that if you are singing in the baritone section, but you're actually a bass, some of the notes are going to be too high for your voice right now, and that is also completely fine. Some baritones in the middle of voice change also only have like 5 notes they can sing until they finish voice change, but they sing those notes really well. So we still need to have them on our team. So basically, if you have any trouble, whether you're soprano, alto, tenor, baritone, or bass, if you have any trouble singing notes that your part is supposed to sing, then you and I can talk about it, and I might just say, okay, just sing the notes that are comfortable, and then lip sync the other ones until your voice finishes changing. Because really, all genders will go through voice change. Just for some people it's more drastic, and for some people it's less noticeable. So for our baritone musical theater example, this is going to be Brooks Ashmankas, who's an American actor. And this is him singing in I'd Give It All For You from Songs for a New World.
I had a house while you were gone. The week after you left me, I found a couple acres near Severna Park. I had a house while you were gone. A house with silver shutters and a driveway laid in marble and thousands of rooms to fill.
Our next example is going to be a jazz singer. Hopefully y'all have heard of Frank Sinatra, who's also an American singer. He's super famous, and this is a little clip of him singing Fly Me to the Moon, one of his most famous songs.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play up there with those stars. Let me see what life is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand.
And our last baritone example is going to be Elvis Presley. So you could probably argue different things about his voice part, but in this particular clip, he does sound pretty much like a baritone, just in the voice range and the tone. So obviously he's an American musician and actor, and this is a little bit of him singing Teddy Bear.
Oh, baby, let me be your loving teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be,
oh, let him be
your old teddy bear.
So sometimes it can be hard to tell right away what other people's voice parts are or what yours is, because there are actually altos and basses that can still sing pretty high, and there are sopranos and tenors who can sing lower than you think also. Really, the most important factor is what is the most comfortable for your voice. For example, I can sing pretty high for smaller sections of songs, but it's easiest for me to sing in the middle to low part of my voice range. And really, that for me is an alto range. So just because you can sing in those other places, higher or lower, doesn't necessarily mean that's where you want to sing all the time. And that's kind of what identifying your voice part is all about. So just as a really quick recap, from high to low, we've got soprano, alto, tenor, baritone, and bass. So let's see if you can figure out what your current voice part is.